Hi, this is Randy with Excel for Freelancer, and welcome. In this week's training, we're going to be going over an inventory manager. And once again, we'll be creating it from the ground up, starting with a blank workbook, and then going over every field, every table, every conditional formatting until we create this amazing inventory manager. This will be part one of a two-part series, so I'm looking forward to bringing this to you. Let's get started. Okay, I'm really excited to bring this inventory manager to you. I've had a lot of requests, so let's get to it. We're going to start with a blank workbook. And the first thing we want to do, just like we did last week in the contact manager, we want to create our first two columns that are reserved for admin. So we're going to color those gray. Those are always going to be, in my videos, often used for admin, and we can hide those columns later on when we complete our project. So that's an important distinction that we have often. Next up, what I want to do is I want to create a title. So we'll increase row one, and then we're going to put our title in there. We'll call this Inventory Manager. And then now we'll go ahead and change the font to Myriad. Probably it's a pretty clear font. And we will take, we'll probably increase the size as well. Myriad Pro Black, that's a pretty good one. And then we'll center that, and then maybe 48 or so, about that's pretty good size. And then italicize, and we're going to give this a color. I want a theme on this. We'll make this one green, so we'll call that a dark green. And then I'm going to give this all the way a fade. Let's just highlight that and give this a fade. It's the background color. So we're going to format those cells, and we're going to color the background. So when we go to fill, then we're going to go to fill effects, and we'll give it a slight, probably a three-step background. So this will contain two, and the row below will contain one. So we'll go from the dark green to a medium green on this one, darker to lighter. And then on the row below it, we're going to go another fade. And then we're going to go to our main background color. So format this row as well. We're going to go to those next greens. So we're going to, on the fill effects on this one, we're going to go from that medium green to the lightest green. And that lightest green is going to be our main background color here. So we'll go down one step below. And then we'll go ahead and give our base color here. We can raise this up a little bit in a moment. So we'll give it that base color here. And then that'll just be the light green, which is our main base color, which is that light green. So now we get this kind of fade effect, which is nice. And so on this, I'm going to keep C column empty just as a space so you can increase or decrease. And I'm going to start our data here in column D there. And then what I want to do is I want to create fields for our inventory manager. The first is I want to create, like, let's say, a customer or a vendor. So we'll start out a customer. And in this one, I want to create two different types. I want to create both the purchase and the sales. I want to use the same screen for both of those. So this field could be customer or could be vendor. And I'll show you how that's going to work later. And we'll skip a row, and then we'll just move to the product number. Product number. And then I want to add some product details in there. So let's go ahead and add some product details. Let's go ahead and call it product name. And then let's see, the standard purchase quantity. I want to know, you know, if we set a product. So we want a standard purchase quantity. And these are product details, so that's going to be very important for products. So we're going to have both sales, purchases, and products all on the same screen. And I'll show you how that's going to work. And then sales quantity here. So that's going to be our first column of data. And let's just kind of make these white just so we can see that they're going to be fields where users enter that. And then I want to do another column over in, let's say, G. So we're going to skip one, have one spacer column. And then G, we're going to put in some more details. So I want to put in, let's say, a transaction date here. And then skip two. And I also want to put in the sales price. That's going to be the item price there. And then I also want, for the product information, These two rows are going to be for product details, right? So we're going to be able to hide that information or show it. So I'll make that distinction very soon, but let's go put in a product type because I want to know the product type. And also want to know a product description. Product description here. So that's very important. I want that. And then I want to put the total here. I want to have the total because it's going to be the quantity times. So this will be a formula. And the idea is what I want to do is I want to have both sales and purchases here, but I want to alternate between purchase and sales. So we can do that with a kind of a button type of thing. So let's go ahead and create that button. Now we're going to use shapes on that. So let's insert a shape here. And let's go ahead and enter the background of that button. We'll use an oval here. And we'll create just a background of that. And let me size that. About let's say about a height of 0.22, and then we'll give it a width of maybe 0.65 or so. And then I want to also zoom in. I want to round those. I want to round it out. So let's go ahead and create that kind of round shape there. That's the kind of one I want. I want a round shape. And let's color the background our border similar to our theme. So we'll use the shape outline, the same of our theme color, which is the dark green. And we'll give it a background, maybe of a gray or something like that, because it's not going to be the main focal point. The button itself will be. And the button's going to be a circle. So let's go ahead and insert that, create a circle on that. And let's go ahead and call it that. And then we'll just give that circle, let's say, point. Let's create, make sure it's even 0.18, because I want it to fit within that. And I'll show you how that works. Not 18, 0.18. And then also 0.18 on that, and then we'll give it a shape color of, let's see, a green. That'll be good. And so border shape fill of green. Let's go the fill of green, and let's do the outline of the little bit darker color there. Okay, so that'll look good. And not so much of an outline really, almost no outline, but just a very light outline. There we go. Okay, so what I want to do is basically I want to be able to click this button and have it move from here to here to here to here, right? And switching between purchase and sales. So we have to designate what is purchase and what is a sale. And let's go ahead and do that. Let's shrink this border. We don't need this border so large. We can shrink it down. The outline of this can be also smaller. It's a little bit big right now. We'll set it to a weight of just let's say 3/4 of a point. That looks good. Okay, so the idea is to use this as a switch so we can switch between purchase and sales. So let's go ahead and make that distinction now, and we'll go ahead and add in a text label here. So this is going to be for purchases, and I'll do it all in caps, purchase. I want to show purchases on that there. And we'll center that. And we don't need any background or any fill or any border on that. It's just going to be for label purposes. So no outline, no fill, purchase. And we want it centered. So that's going to be for purchase. And also, let me go ahead and we don't need any padding on that. So let's under size and properties, move along to, and we'll set that to the text box. We can set these to zero. So, because we have no border, so it's no need for that. All right, so we've got that good. Let's go ahead and copy and paste that. We can use it for sales. This one's going to be sales on this side. So I want to switch between sales and purchases. And if we click here, it's going to go to the right for sales. If we click here, it's going to go for purchases. Then we're going to make changes based on that. All right, that'll be good. So we'll use VBA to make that, but right now I want to set up our admin area. So the first is I want to know what transaction type. So let's set transaction type, and we'll start it off at purchase so we can set that up. And we also want to know the selected row. We're going to have a table of transactions below here, and I want to know what the row is for that. So list is the selected row for the transaction. So we'll put transaction row. And we also want to know if it's a new transaction, new trans, And then that can be true or false, so we'll mark it true for now. And we also want to know if it's the transaction is going to be loading. That's very important. Those three items, so if the transaction is loading or not. When we select a transaction from the item from the table below, we want all the data to appear here. So we need to know if it's loading or not. So we will set it's a, if it's a loading transaction load, and that's going to be true or false. All right, so we've got that. Let's size it up. And let's color those differently so we know that they're admin. We'll give it, say, an orange background so we know we give it their admin color, and also put some borders on it so it's clear that those are going to be admin. I also want to designate for the products, we're going to be adding new products and updating products, so we need some product information on that. So let's go ahead and add in some there. Product row, we need to know that. We also need to know if it's a new product. And we also need to know if its product is loading. So kind of the same three types of fields. Product load, and that's going to be all true or false. So let's just say, you know, we have a product row here. True, this is going to be true or false. And this is going to be true or false as well. So those items are important. So let's go ahead and color those, give it the same information. And let's say we're going to use, well, table is, a table will probably start right on 17. So let's, I'm going to use 16 for the mapping. So let's call this the hide row. And we're going to use this for our table. So our table, we're going to leave this blank. C is going to be for spacer. So we're going to start our table right here on 17, and our mapping will go in 16. So we'll color this gray all the way to say K. And I want to color this gray because I want to hide this. We're going to use that for our mapping, and I'll show you how that works in just a little bit. So let's go ahead and color this gray. This row is intended to be hidden. Our actual table or headers will start on 17. So let's put in that information. We want transaction type. And we want a vendor or customer. They're going to go in the same row. And then next up, we want probably transaction date. We need all of the information from the above fields into this table below. Product number, we want that, the price of that, as well as the quantity and the total, and then maybe some notes. So that's going to be our table. And then we're going to have our data below here. So let's clear the colors out of that. And we'll add in some information, some data, conditional formatting as well. Let's format this, center those, and that will adjust the column heights. That's too much. Let's bring it over here. The reason it's too much is because we have to merge and center this. So we can do that, merge and center. Now, if we automatically, we need it a little bit bigger. Now, if we automatically click those, there we go. We're almost there. We got to just increase some rows. Notes, of course, is going to be larger. We'll need some for that, the total. So we're good. We'll size them accordingly a little bit later on, but they're okay for now. We will hide. This is going to be our header row, so let's color that accordingly. We'll format the cells. That's off the screen here. Let's scroll up a little bit. We will highlight this, format the cells here, and then we'll color those. We'll give it a dark green border. Same with our theme color. And we'll go a little thicker on the outsides. And the insides, we will keep the thin line here and here. And then we'll give it a filter color here and the fill color here. Fill effects, a little bit of a fade as well, working with our theme. All right, that'll be good. There you can see it there. Okay, so we've got our make it bold and green, color that green, the dark green. So now we've got our theme and our header covered. We will add our border in here as well. So right click that same border, and I'm going to format those cells. Sorry, that was off the screen a little bit. And then we're going to use that same color, but thicker borders on the side. And then we'll use the dotted line for our center dividers. We won't use any horizontal. I'll use conditional formatting for that. Let's add in our conditional formatting right now for our table. New rule, we're going to use mod, and that's going to be our formula that colors equal mod, and this is going to color our even rows. We'll give it a light green, format that, And I know there's quicker ways to format a table, but I want to show you how it's done here. We'll go with that light green, but maybe a little bit lighter than that so that it's contrasting. And we'll go with this little bit lighter there. Okay, so now we've colored the even rows using mod row 2 equals 0. And there we go. Okay, so our table's set, and we have our, let's go ahead and work on our information here. This increased in size, which we don't want because we need to set it. 0.65 is what we wanted at. The reason is we have to make sure that we size, do not size cells. So let's go ahead and set that up. Right click, properties. We always want to make sure that we do not size with the cells so that we don't have to continue changing them. Move, but don't size with cells. That's the setting we want. So now we can reset the size back to what we want. Zoom in and shrink this down. Now that it won't, now as we increase or decrease our column widths, our shapes won't move around. So that's good. We can bring all this over a little bit so that it's within the area that we're focused on. All right, there we go. And bring that over here. This way, everything's centered over. We're going to use this area for our header row. So we'll put our buttons here. We're going to create, add new transaction buttons, delete transactions, add photos, and things like that. This area will be for our title, and our title is going to be based on our types. So, for example, if this says purchase, it's going to say purchase transaction. So let's go ahead and write that in now. I'll put it somewhere about here. And let's call this equals because it's going to be based on the type. So equals if, and then we'll say this equals purchase. Then we want this to equal purchase transaction. Otherwise, sales transaction. So that way we can have both. Okay, good. Now we are set. Okay, so now our title is going to, let's increase that. We want this, I want it middle and I want it bold, and I'm going to increase the font so that we can. All right, that's good. And italicize bold. And we'll underline it too. There we go. So now we know it's a purchase transaction, but if this changes to sales, then the title's going to change as well. We can even make that a little bit bigger so it's clear. I want to make sure it's very clear what type of transaction that the user. So when they change this, when they change it, oh, it's going to change automatically. In fact, let's go ahead and write that macro right now so that we can quickly change it back and forth. We're going to go into the VBA, the Visual Basic. And you know what? Before we do that, let's go ahead and save this project. We don't want to lose any of the work we've been doing. Always save it. All right, inventory manager, and then we'll give it an XLS, inventory manager, and then make sure it's got XLS. Then this will contain macro, so we want to make sure we give it that. There we go. And all right, so now we've done that, and let's go create a module, insert module, and we will call this module. Let's give it some the sheet macros because I want to create some macros based on the sheet. So we will give it a name and the properties and sheet macros. All right, so those are macros that we're going to focus on the sheet. So that's going to be our starting point. All right, so let's now that we have that module, we can create a button sub move button. We can use the same macro for both move left or right. So that's what we want to do now. So we've got a macro. Before we continue with our macro, we want to name our shapes. That's always a good idea. The part that we want to move, let's give it a name back into that. We'll call this little icon. We'll call that move button so that we know. Move button. Okay, now that's done, we can set up with sheet one. We're going to be working with that so we can focus on that. Let's go ahead and say, if we need to know if we're going to be moving our shape back and forth, we need to know what the current condition is. In other words, I need to know if it's purchase, then I need to move it to sales. If it's currently sales, I need to move it back to purchase. So from left to right, right to left, we need to know that. So Let's go ahead and first determine what our current status is. So we can write an if-then statement. If dot range B1 equals purchase, then do something, okay? Else do something else, okay? So if it's purchase, what are we going to do? Well, what we want to do is we want to move it to the right if it's purchase. So let's go ahead and write that in dot shapes move button dot increment left 30. That's going to move it to the right. Left would be negative 30. And then we also want to set B1 to sales, right? If it's currently purchased, we need to make it sales. So dot range B1 dot value equals sales. All right, so we've got that covered. Else, what if it's not? If it's else, it's going to be pretty much the opposite. We're going to move it negative 30. Else, negative 30, right? The other direction. And then we want to set this to purchase. B1 should be purchased. So copy and paste that and set it to purchase. That'll set it up right there. Let's take a look at that and see how we have. But there's more we need to add in this macro a little bit later on. But for now, we just want the simple button movement, and we need to assign that macro to this button. I'm going to assign this macro to both this shape and this shape, to both of them. So I'm holding down the control on both. Right click, assign macro. We only have one macro created, so move button. All right, let's take a look. All right, let's set is currently on purchases, so let's set it to purchases. And now we can click on it. All right, that's perfect. Now that's the one we want. And we see at this name changes. So good. Now we've got that. Let's move this over a little bit to the left just to line it up. Let's take a look now. Zoom in. Let's take a look so we can see how that looks zoomed in. It's not quite centered as I like it, but we'll fix that in a second. All right, let's center everything. Highlight over it, format, align, middle. There we go. Now it looks good. That looks just right. Okay, perfect. Good. Now we've got our macro that switches between purchase and sales. And we're going to need that because there's going to be a sales transaction or a purchase transaction. Okay, so we're good with that. Let's continue on. All right, let's color our fields in white. We'll select on our fields here. And we want to make sure that we have just those fields where values are going to go in white so we can clearly see them apart. Okay. And now also what I want to do is I want to make the distinction of what is a purchase and what is a sales, not only by the title, but I also want the colors. So let's then set these colors for sales in blue and purchases in red. That's kind of a theme that I want to give it. So that's going to be important. And let's set the product description a little bit wider. Do that. And that's we will merge and center that. Merge and center and then give it off to the left so it's got left justification note. And we also need notes here too. That's important. Notes. We'll use the same thing for here. I want it all. All right, good. Notes should also be merged in center and left, actually merge center and then left justified. Okay, that's good. That'll give us our fields as we know. We're going to put a picture in here and some buttons in here so that we can add pictures. And I also want to put the quantity on hand. Quantity on hand. So we know how much we have, and that'll go in here. Let's just put a spacer like 5, and that'll be a formula very soon. All right, quantity on hand. All right, so in order to differentiate between these, the purchase and the sales, let's make some colors and then we'll use conditional formatting. I'd like to color the font of these blue on sales and a darker red on purchase. So I will color these right now blue. Let's give it a blue color. And let's choose a color that's a little bit standing out. Maybe this blue here, that kind of stands out. Okay. We'll use that blue because I really want to differentiate. When we're going to use both sales and purchases, we need to differentiate between those colors. Now I'll also give it a border color, which is also going to be different for both purchases and sales. So let's create a border. And the reason is I'm highlighting these fields in a way that it's independent. So when we right-click and format those cells, everyone's going to be formatted the same. And let's give it a border. Use the same color, which is this blue one here, and I'll give it a all the way around plus a dotted line in the center, which is going to be our divider. That is our data. Okay, good. That's what I want for sales. And now for purchases, I'm going to have a darker red, but I also want to color the background of it. So let's give it this faded background. I'm going to do a slight fade of a blue. So we're going to go from green to blue. I don't know if it's going to be the most beautiful, but I want to differentiate between sales and purchases, and I want to make it very clear because just the title is not enough. So fill effects. We're going to start out with this green here, which is what we already have, and then we'll go on to a little bit of a bluer contrast. Maybe this blue here. Yeah, that looks good. Okay. So the rest is going to be with this blue, and then we can use conditional formatting to color it blue. So here we have this blue, and I'm going to bring this blue all the way through here, and then everything but the fields in which the user is going to enter data, we're going to give it that blue. That blue is going to change to red on purchases. On purchases, that blue is going to change to red. So keep that in mind. And as I highlight all of the cells that are going to be affected, and I also will use fields in which there is a constant in which the user doesn't edit. So that's the color I want to give it. Let's go ahead and give it that blue. Not that color. Let's go ahead and give it that blue, which is this one right here. All right, that's a good distinction. Now it's kind of looks odd with the color change here, so I'm going to give it a border around that, kind of a circular border. So we'll insert the shapes. And I'll use this rounded rectangle. And I'll bring it all the way up here and I'll just surround that. And then we'll bring the corners in very tight so they're not very well rounded. And we don't want to fill on that, so no fill. What I want to do is I want to hug this, and I'm going to use our theme color, which is that dark green. And therefore, that way gives it a nice blend there, and it doesn't look good. So let's go ahead and put that in green, and we'll give us the outline of that dark green, which is our theme color. Okay, good. So now we see what it's going to look like for our sales. Purchases are going to be red, but we'll use conditional formatting to do that. I think we've got it covered now. We can products can or cannot be colored. I'm not sure about that. We'll see how it looks. In other words, these are specifically for products. And we're going to be able to hide and show these. Let's give it a shape. We can start adding in buttons soon so we can see how this will come. Gonna insert some shapes for buttons. We're going to use our theme color and our theme shape. I'm gonna rounded rectangle. That color is going to be a darker green. We'll use maybe a dark green shape fill. We're going to use that dark green here. We'll use that as our theme color here. We can create multiple buttons for that. We don't want too many. We're going to add the photo. We want to delete a transaction. And we'll use a, we want to delete it. All right, so let's go. We'll just create these buttons there. I think we've got a few too many. There. This will be add photo. We can bring in our shapes and we can bring in our a differentiate. I want a different button to hide. This is product information right here. These from rows 9 through 10 are product information. So I want the ability to hide those rows. What I want it to do is I want to do this. I want to hide product information. Sometimes we want to see details on the product, sometimes we don't. So I want to hide, actually it's going to be 4 rows total, so we'll do probably also hide 12. So the idea is to just have your transaction information here, and then when you want to see the product information, you can enter the product, you can enter the sales price, but when you want to see or update the product information, you'll unhide rows 9 through 12. So we're going to do that, and I'm going to do that through VBA. But I want to create some shapes that we can control the hiding and unhiding of that. So let's enter a shape, something like not an arrow, but probably like this. We'll enter this one for hiding and one for showing. So insert, and then we'll do just the opposite of that shape, which is the up arrow, which is here. So these are the two shapes, and let's size them and also color them. We know the fill, and we know the style is here. So let's fill that again. All right, so that's it. We duplicated that. We don't need that. All right. Okay, so we have our shapes here. Let's go ahead and give it the theme that we like, which is the green, and then the fill that we also are using. So that's consistent. And now we'll put it a size on that. All right, selecting these and set them 0.61 and let's say 0.98. That'll give us a good, they're at least the same, so we can align them. And what I want to do is I want to use one to hide and one to show, and then we'll put them on top of those. So we'll use this one to hide details and this one to show the details. Show details. All right. Of course, we're going to set the text so that there's no padding around it so that all the text shows up. Go back into the formats here and under the text box. We can set the right for a very little bit, 0.01, and then perhaps 0 on the left. I'll put the icon on the left, the top and the bottom don't need it. We will center that vertically, so that should be fine. Let's center that. All right. And now let's put it off to the right. Actually, I'll center it and then I'll use spaces because I want to move it over to the right, but I want to keep basically the same format. I just want to give some room for the icon that we're going to add in there. So that's all I want to do. There we go. So, and then I'll do the same thing for the hide. I want to leave some room for the icon. And we'll import those icons in just a moment. All right, so now we've got our two buttons, show details, hide details. Let's bring in the shapes that we're going to be putting in inserting pictures. I've got a folder here with some preset pictures so we don't have to go searching around for them. All right, here they are. Let's go. We're going to select all pictures. I've got some icons in there, so we want to select all. And I'll just use just these icons that we're going to use. The shirts are going to come in later as we add packages. So I've added all of the pictures that we're going to be adding in. I'll use this one for the ads. Make that point two. Bring them smaller. And I think the others as well. This is going to be our main icon for the, all right, for the inventory, the top part. So that's going to be our icon here. So we can zoom that in. We'll use that as our header, our main icon to use for our shape. All right, that looks good. Bring it down just a little bit. Give a little bit more spacing onto that. And then we'll make this a little bit smaller. Now what I want to do is I want to add buttons here, but let's size them all together and also bring them to the top. Actually, we're going to use just these. Set those to, all right, 0.2 will give us a decent height for that. And we will create our buttons. We want one for new transaction. New transaction. We want another one for delete transaction. And I also want another one, cancel, new, and then save transaction. There's going to be two different button sets. Going to have a new button set and existing. And we can format them all the same. Set the middle and off to the right because we're going to be adding icons on the right side. So we can set up, we'll use this one for our new. Bring that over there. For our cancel, we'll use this. Cancel new. We'll size that button accordingly. This we'll use for save. And this we'll use for delete, which we need to increase this. Okay, now let's fix our button sizes. Increase delete a little bit so we can fit that in there. And we'll also group these buttons too. Okay. And cancel, we can shrink that button. That button doesn't need to be that big. And save a little bit bigger on that, but it's almost perfect. All right, that's good. And we can center. Let's go ahead and center. Can highlight those. those buttons here, and then what we'll do is we'll just format a line all the middle, so all the icons and buttons are lined up accordingly. Now we're ready to group them. Bring this cancel in a little bit smaller there. And holding the control, and then we'll group it first and then we'll name it. Cancel. We're going to use cancel transaction. Actually, cancel transaction button. We want that. We want save transaction. We want that grouped. We'll name that save trans button. And then we're going to group these two because this is for new. It's going to be a new transaction group. So these two are only going to be visible when we have a new transaction. We can save it and cancel it. Those are going to be our only options. So we want to group these two. So let's group them and then give it a name for that group. So we're going to call this new transaction group. And likewise, these two, we're going to name them and then group them. So let's go ahead and name that. Group them first, group into a single button, then new transaction button. All right, and then this one here as well. Group it and name it, and then we'll call that delete. Delete trans DEL is fine, small. Okay, so we've got that. Now we're going to group these two buttons together. Group those, and then we're going to call that existing. That's existing transaction button. So we can hide, show these. Now these two groups are not going to be shown at the same time. So we can make them align. Align the top so they both get at the top, and then align the middle as well. And we'll align the left probably. All right, because they're not going to be shown at the same time. It's going to be either or. Now we can align the center. That way they're centered at the same. Those two groups are not going to be shown at the same time. So now we've got that. I want to create one more button for show image. I'm out of buttons. Let's go ahead and copy this. Control C. If we do Control D, it's going to group it, but it's going to stay in the same group. We don't want it. I want to do a new. So I want to create a new button, and I want to add this for add picture. All right, good. Now we're going to bring this over here. And I'm going to bring that to the front. Notice it's behind, so we need to bring it to the front. So bring to the front. And perfect. Okay, that looks good. Align that. Make sure they're aligned in the middle. Group them as we do and give it a name. Add pick button. I always like the button because when you click on all the buttons, you want to see a nice, I want to know the names of all of these. I want to see them so I can see exactly what is what. If I have just things like text box or up, down arrow, that's not really helpful. I want to know what they are. So I try to name each and every one as much as possible. Now we'll create our show details. All right, 0.26. Let's go ahead and set that size. All right, that looks good. And we'll copy and paste that. We'll use the same icon for both. I'm cheating. All right, good. Hide details, show details. We're going to group that. And we'll call this show detail button. And then we're going to group this and call this hide detail button. So you see a pattern how it's working so that you can use the same pattern yours. Hide detail button. A group. It's a group, but either way. What did I name the other one? I forgot now. Too busy talking. Okay, button. And we should keep them consistent. Button, not group. Button. All right, fair enough. They're both the same now. Show detail button, hide detail button. And then what we can do is we're going to put those right on top of each other because they're not going to be shown at the same time. So we can align the middle. And then I'm going to bring that up. It looks kind of funny the way it is, but of course, only one's going to be shown at the same time. We're going to be hiding 8, 9 through 12. 9 through 12, so we can bring them down just. And we want to highlight them both. We just draw a square around them and bring them down. So we're going to assign macros to them, and they're going to be hiding. So we know that. So we got our buttons. Now we've got our ready. They're going to be only shown at the same time. All right, what's next? Let's do our conditional formatting for our purchases. Because we got sales, so let's do our purchases now. Next up, let's go ahead and set those conditional formats. What I want to do is I want to create the font colors of dark red, so let's highlight those, and those are just on the labels here. on purchases so that the font becomes red for these items on purchases, at least for the labels. As we selected it, we can go ahead and click on conditional formatting and we'll add a new rule. It's going to be a very simple rule here. We'll use a formula and we want B1 equal to purchases. And in that case, we want the font to be a dark red color, probably this color. Let's go ahead and click the font. And we'll use the second from the bottom here. I'll set it to this. Click OK. All right. Now we've got that. Let's click on the OK. It's working well. Now we've gone from blue to red. I also want to set the background. I want to change the background as well. Let's go ahead and highlight the background just as we did, but this time we're going to use conditional formatting on it. And we'll add some rules to that. We can add two rules for the background, one for the upper fade and one for the main background color. But first, I want to select all of the affected cells so that we can change the background on those. All right, now I've got everything but the white, so we can create a new conditional formatting under new rules and use a formula. Again, we'll use the same formula. A fill of a light red here. We'll use this color here, and that'll be fine. And we can give it a rule. Let's click on B1 equal to purchase. All right, and apply that. Click OK and apply that, and we see it changes to red. All right, that's good. Now we just have to set the upper fade to the same rule, conditional formatting. New rule, but we can use the same formula. Use a formula. B1 equaling purchases equal purchase. All right, and then this time we're going to use a fade here from the green to the red. So fill effects, because this one will have that fade using our basic background green color. And then we're going to fade it right into the red color. So that's the one, green to red. Click OK, OK. And there we go. Now we're good. Now when we click on sales, purchases and sales, now they look very different and very distinct. We can even change the font. I like that. We could even do a font color here. Oh, let's change the main font to blue. We can even go a darker blue on that, a little bit darker here. And then we can do a conditional formatting for that as well, for a darker red, so we can really differentiate between sales and purchases. And the same rule here equals purchase. And then we'll give it a dark red font on this one so that it ties in with the theme of the purchases. So we'll go with this color here and make it bold. That should be bold already. Regular is fine. Okay. And click OK. Now go purchases. Purchases have different names. And now here we've got customer. We've got a formula here. Let's copy that formula. I want that formula. But in this case, customer is going to be on purchases, but on sales, it's going to be vendors. So let's change that to a formula. If equals purchase, then I want it to be a customer. However, if it's a purchase, excuse me, if it's a purchase, and we'll paste that in there. All right, so if it's a purchase, if you're making a purchase, I want it to be a vendor. And if it's sales, I want it to be a customer. Okay, we sell to customers, we buy from vendors, so we want it to vendor. All right, that looks good. Let's just add some colons onto that. And then we'll right justify it as well, all of the fields. Same thing here. And we also need to add in our borders. Let's get those borders red too. We want to make it look. All right, now we can right justify it. All of our fields so that everything's consistent. And then right justify it. Let's do the borders too. All right, holding down the control. Let's do that again. Holding down the control. And then we're going to make our borders a maroon as well so that everything is very consistent. All right, so what I'll do is I'm going to use borders for conditional formatting too. Conditional formatting, new rule. We're going to use the same rule. If it equals purchases, we're going to make it a dark red border. That is going to be B1 equals purchase. And then the border here. Border is going to be a dark red, so let's go ahead and set that all the way around. Give it that color, and then go all the way around. Okay. There we go. Now it's going to give us some kind of style. All right, now we see everything changed to blue. Now it's very distinct, so I like that. Now our purchases and sales look very different. All right, we're good with conditional formatting, and let's move on to some additional mapping for data. We'll move on to data mapping. All right, the idea is that this data, the transaction data, which is in these fields and these fields, I want to get into here. So we need to map those datas with the data above. So we can start in the transaction type. That's going to be B1. The vendor and customer, that will be E5. So we're mapping with the cell addresses there. The transaction date, that's going to be H5, while the product is going to be E7. The price, of course, will be H7. Got H7 for the price there. For the quantity, we have E13. That's important. And for the total, we're going to leave that blank out. It's going to be a formula. And the note is going to be J13. So now we've got that mapped out. That's going to help us. Let's go ahead and center that. We're going to hide it. When we save our information to the table, that's going to help us map the data into the table here. And I've got some sample data we'll put in. We also want to map it the other direction. So let's copy and paste all of this and move it over. We don't necessarily need move it over here to N5, starting there in N5, and we're going to paste it. And then we're going to remove the conditional formatting. Of course, we don't need it here. And then conditional formatting will just clear those from the selected cells. We don't need the pictures as well, so we can hide those. We can delete those pictures that came up. Those are not necessary. I'm just looking for the particular cell spacing so we can put in our columns here so we can map those columns accordingly as we map them. And I'll show you how that's going to work a little bit later, but basically we want to size them with the columns accordingly so that when we bring the data, it's automatically coming in. So we can do that. Let's set those up now. The customer will be in column 5, right? That's going to be here, E is column 5, right? F is 6, G is 7, and so forth. So we can set those up. Now the product number is going to be 7, while the transaction date will be 6. So we can put in that. And the sales price is going to be 8. So this is mapping our data, and I'll show you how that works as well. We're going to leave the product information empty for now, but we're going to put that in a little bit. The sales quantity is going to be 9, and the total is going to be 10. I also want a place for our picture link. So let's put that here, picture link, because we're going to add pictures. And I want to make sure that that has a place as well. So let's make that white so we can put in a picture link there. And we know that our picture for the products is going to go there. All right, so we're set up there. And next up, we have, let's just move that over and we can shrink this. We don't need this too much. Okay, so we've got our information and we can shrink these. They're just going to contain small numbers, so we don't need a lot of it, a lot of space there. And what we want to do now is we've got our data mapping. Let's name our sheets here. Let's call this transactions. I'm going to have three total sheets here. And the next up, I want to have another sheet for products. I'm going to keep our products on a separate table. So let's do that. And a third sheet for setup, which is going to contain two lists. I want here I want our customers and our vendors in a list. So let's go ahead and add those in. Customers and then vendors. We'll just set up some sample lists here. Very, very simple. I'm just looking for the name because I want to create a drop-down list. So I have some data in another. Let's bring in the data here, but let's map out our products first so that we can get our products table located here. We'll start out in D here, just for a second, call that products. And our products contain multiple criteria. So we're gonna first have a product number and a product name. We also want a sales price. Want a type there as well. And quantity on hand, this is gonna be a formula. So we know how many we have, which is, of course, is gonna be the total purchases minus the sales. It's pretty simple, using some ifs. We'll get into that in a little bit. Wanna know the purchase quantity. So if we purchase it often, we wanna know how much we're purchasing. What is the normal amount or the default amount that we're purchasing? And a product description. And of course the picture link we want. Okay, so we've got our basic database titles, headers set up here. Let's space it out accordingly. And I'll merge and center this. Let's capitalize that. And increase this. And let's go ahead and make it bold and choose another font to separate it. Give it a format so we can easily see it. We'll go from maybe a blue, fill it effects, and we'll use a blue fade on this, going to maybe a medium blue to a lighter blue. And then we'll go in their header, we'll just choose a different fade as well, so we give it a nice look. Okay, and then on our headers, we'll also do the same, another fade, but just a bit lighter of a blue so that we can set that up. The fill effects will go from medium to light blue. So here's our medium, and then our light blue is here. That's how we give it a nice fade effect from all the way from the header, for the title to the header. Okay, so now we're set up with that. And we can give it a border, format, cells. And we'll give it a thick border, a blue border, just kind of give it our table a nice look. It's not really important for creation, but if you want to, I'll show you how to give it a nice look. Of course, you can format as a table too. That's very easy, but I wanted to show you some different ways so that you can see how to do that if you want to increase your data and add formatting a table is easy, but I have a very specific like, and I don't necessarily like, they look kind of boring, the formats table. So we'll give it a border there and there and there. Okay, so now we're good, and add some conditional formatting. Alternate lines lets us help see the data easier. So we're going to add a new rule here and use mod so we can color the even rows, and equals mod. Okay, that's gonna automate. And then we'll give it a blue, light blue. That's our theme for our products. So we'll use this blue, and then a little bit lighter color, no fade on that. So a little bit lighter, just so it's contrast, so we can easily see the data accordingly. Okay, all right, good. And now I have some data, let's go and save it and import, bring in some data. I've created some data because there's no reason for me to add in all that data. It's gonna be, so I've got some sample data here we can bring in there. Customers we'll put in here. And I'll just go ahead and copy and paste that into our bring setup as the first row. And then vendors, bring that in as well. Just so it's a faster, this way we can quickly get to the important fun parts about it. And I've got some transaction here, some transaction information here. That's gonna help us out. So we'll bring that into the transaction sheet so we can quickly, and I'm just gonna paste values here. And also for products, I've got some products, so we can go back in there and add some products as well. So that this is a little bit quicker, save some time, and copy that, and then I'll paste that, and then we're going to be done with our data. This will help us get to the good parts of it. All right, don't worry about that, it's not important. All right, we're good there. We also want to map the data on our product, and we want to map it from the beginning. So I want to make sure, so remember, we want to map our product information here so we know how to map it back to that. So our product number is in E7. Our product name is an E5. Let's go ahead and make those capitals. E7 and then E5. We also want our sales price. That is an H7. And our type is an H9. Then our quantity on hand, that is located. That's going to be a formula as well, so we don't need a thing on that. We don't need mapping on that. And then E11 for our purchase quantity, E11. Product description is H11 back in the sheet one. And then our is going to be, I believe, O14. Let me just double check that on that. O14, yes, for our picture link is going to be O14. So we want to map it. So we've got all that mapped. We can center that, so it's a little bit easier. We know what column it's over. And everything but the quantity on hand. Let's go ahead and double click on the column so we can size that accordingly, but not the picture link. All right, so we are good there. Now we can move back into the transactions and we can start building this out. But before we get into the VBA, I want to name some ranges here. So that's going to help us in VBA and in our formulas. So let's do that. In the setup screen, I want to use a named range for customers so we can add that. And I want to use offset so that that grows as we grow our customer list, then that name grows. So into the formulas, name manager, and we'll create a new one and we'll call this customers and we'll give it an offset. So we can highlight this for now. And I want to use offset and then setup starting at C4 and gonna click the comma three times. Count A, and we're going to count all the way. We can increase this to 99. So we're going to count all the way, count all the values with text, and then we're going to use that as our dynamic comma one, just one column there. And that is it. Let's click OK. And now we're going to tab over and just check it. All right, good. It looks good. It's set. It's highlighted all of our customers. We're going to do the same thing for vendors, new vendors. And then for what? This is going to actually be E, so we can use E, starting off at E4, and then using offset. And then it's going to, we can make this E, and then copy that just so we don't have to write it again. Then we're going to add three commas in after the four, count A again. And then what are we counting? All the way from E to 999, that's fine, comma one, okay. There we go, E4 through E99. Now we're going to click OK. We're going to tab over, check it to make sure that it encompasses all of our vendors. Good. So now we've got vendors and customers set up. I also want to do product numbers. So let's go into products and I want to create a name range for product numbers. So let's highlight that. Also going to use offset each time. Name manager, new. And then we'll create product numbers. Okay, that's good. And we're gonna use offset here. Copy, let's go ahead and copy that range there. We're gonna use offset again, offset. And then again, three commas, count A, then parentheses, and then we're gonna paste in that range, increase it so it encompasses all the possible data. Add comma one, close parentheses. Okay, so now we've got that in there. Let's go ahead and tab over and check to make sure that it's correct, that encompasses all of our data. Okay, good. So now we have it. Now we're gonna add in some named ranges for the transactions. I wanna know the transaction types. I want to know the product number and I want to know the quantity, also the quantity. So I'm going to create named ranges for all of those, but I'm going to use this as our main. I'm going to use this as our main counting the transactions since this is always required in every single one. We're going to use this and then we're going to count these, but use these as our. So let's go ahead and show you how to do that. Under the name manager, again, create new. This time we're going to call it trans, and then we'll have each one for quantity. So let's do transaction type. That's the first one. That's the one we're on now. We're going to highlight this, keep that, copy and save that. Count, offset. Offset transaction starting at D, three commas again, comma. Count A. Paste in our values and then let's go to 9999 And then we can do comma one. Okay, good. So we're set. Let's go ahead and copy and paste this. We're gonna be using this for the next three, except the only difference is our starting point, our starting cell is gonna be different. So in fact, we can copy the entire offset. Click OK. And now tab over, make sure it's correct. Okay, good. Let's go ahead and create new ones for the quantity and for the product number. So trans underscore QTUA quantity. And then we're going to paste in the entire formula, but we're going to change quantity is located in column I. So let's change just this, the starting point, I, and click OK. Now tab over, and we'll make sure that it encompasses. All right, good. Now we only have our product number to do. So new trans product number. Okay, so now we've got that, and that is of course in column G, so we're gonna paste over, paste it all, keep D as well, but just change D here in the first part to column G, our starting point. Click OK, tab over to check to make sure that all of our data is included. Perfect. Okay. All right, I know I'm moving a little quick. We got a lot to cover, so we're good. Now we've got all of our name ranges. Let's just take a look at them all. Just so we have customers, we have vendors, both in the setup screen. We have product number, and that's in our products. We also have the transaction quantity, the transaction product number, and transaction type, all part of the transaction. We're going to need that for our formulas and our database, so we've got all of that done now. So now we can move on. Let's go ahead and save. All right, moving on. We also want to ready to start VBA. Let's go ahead and get into that and go with the on-sheet macros. Now, the idea is when I select a particular line here, I want that information to show up here. And I also want the transaction row here to show up. So let's go ahead and put in a row. Let's just put in 21 here. And we also want a conditional format that so we know what row is selected. We can highlight this table and add conditional formatting for our selected row. Under Home, conditional formatting, new rule. And we'll use our theme green, use a formula equals, that's going to be B2 row, R-O, row, and then beginning and end close parentheses. We're going to format that, give it a contrasting fill effect. So that it's very different than what it looks like in normal state. So we'll give it a fade color from dark green to light green, or vice versa. And also we'll take the font bold and put it to white so we can clearly see that that's been selected white. Okay. All right. And that looks different. There we go. So now we can see very well, which is one. So when we select on it, it's going to change this to our selected row so we can easily see which one has been selected. All right, we've covered a ton already in this first part of the Inventory Manager. So I look forward to bringing you a lot more in next week's part two, including all the VBA. Thank you very much for joining me today.